Hi, welcome to an Arduino step-by-step course by Robojax. In this video, we are going to see how we can use this barometric pressure and temperature sensor BMP180. As you can see here, we will be able to see the temperature, the barometric pressure, and also relative pressure and all those information. This is the module, and this is the actual Bosch BMP180, not everything. So this is BMP180, and it operates with up to 3.6 volts. So we have a voltage regulator here that gets 5 volts. Or maybe a little higher to convert it to 3 volts, and we have 4 pin here, and there is a screw hole for this. We have VN, which you connect it to 5 volts of Arduino ground, and then SCL, that's clock, and then signal for clock, signal for data. DA will be connected to A4, and SCL will be connected to A5. Width of this is 10.5 millimeter. The length of the device is 13 millimeter. Depth of the module is 2.5 millimeter. There is a data sheet. This is made by Bosch, a German manufacturer, and BMP180. This is called digital pressure sensor. And here is a quick key feature from 300 to 110 hectopascal. And at the sea level between these values, so it can measure up this much pressure. The supply voltage is 1.8 to 3.6, but because we are using external regulator, then we will have we can operate it with 5 volts and above, up to 12 volts. And then the package is 3.6 by 3.8, which means it's almost squared. So the other one, BMP280, is not squared. So from this, you know which model you're working with, and the interface is I2C, and also it has a temperature sensor included. So typical application, it can be in your mobile phone, navigation system, weather, and also vertical velocity indication, which means because it shows the pressure, from that we know if something goes up and down, the pressure changes, so it can be used for that purpose. Here are some characteristics: the temperature, the operational condition. This operating temperature is between these values, so if you keep it out of this range, it will not function properly, but full accuracy is between 0 to 65. And then the supply voltage is or these values. Supply current, that you can see, it has 3, 5 under these different conditions, up to 32 microampere, which is very minimal, so this is very low. And during the conversion, it's 1000 microampere or 1 milliampere. So relative accuracy in terms of pressure between the 950 and 1050 hectopascal is plus minus 0.12 hectopascal, and then absolute value is plus 2 in terms of accuracy. Conversion time pressure. So ultra low pressure mode. At this is minimum, the typical, or the maximum is 4.5 milliseconds it takes. In terms of temperature, again, this is the value, and serial clock is 3.4 in case if you need it. So this device has VN, ground, signal for clock, signal, data, so SDA and SCL. This VN is connected to 5 volts. So this VN is connected to 5 volts, ground is connected to the ground, and SDA is connected to SDA, or we are connecting it to A4, and SCL is connected to A5. So my Arduino has both pins here, SDA and SCL. I'm connecting it. Otherwise, SDA will be connected to A4 and SCL will be connected to A5. The link for this library from Adafruit, BMP180H. This wire is for the I2C or I2C communication, so we need to include this. I will give you the link for this so you can download it either from robojax.com or from the provided source. The first thing we do is we are creating the pressure instance of the object for this, and then we will use this across this code. And then the only data that you provide is your current location, that you go to Google Map and then type and get this by typing your city name and location and say elevation. So this is my location, which is in Ajax, Ontario, Canada. And then inside the setup, we are initializing the serial monitor. This is a monitor that is displaying, and 9600 bar is this value. If it doesn't match, if these two are not the same, you will not be able to read it. And then this will just print the text. And here we say pressure begin. We are checking it because this will return true. If it's true, this will be printed on the screen. Else, it will print fail. So you have to get this success at the beginning of the code, which is this one. And then the loop starts. The loop is a value. As you can see here, if it fails, we put while 1. That is pausing forever. So every time you need to pause forever, just put while and inside put 1. Inside the loop, this is a character status. This is just one character. And then these are the double variables, capital T, P, P0, and then A. So these are the variables that we need. Then we first print this empty line. This is the one. And then we print provided altitude, as you can see here. And then this altitude is the one that we have provided. So it prints 90, as you can see here. And then altitude multiplied by this factor to give you the feet. So this gives you the feet. Then we are getting pressure dot start temperature, and then we get temperature, and then T. This is the variable that we have here for the temperature. This variable. This works. The variable, the value will be stored in T, in capital T, which is in Celsius. So we print this text, temperature, and then this T is this value, and 2 means with 2 decimal points, so 0.26, and then we print this text. After that, we are converting T with this formula to convert it to Fahrenheit. So this shows here. Then the start pressure, number 3, this is for pressure, and it will return true if it is able to get the pressure. And here we say pressure and temperature, the two value, when it gets the pressure. Then the absolute pressure is printed with this P here, and then with 2 decimal point and millibar at the end. And then we get the same P multiplied by this factor to get mercury inch mercury value. And here we are getting another value. Here we are passing T, by the way, the temperature, and we are getting the pressure. And here we are getting the relative value. Here we are passing the pressure and altitude. So we are pushing our altitude and the pressure. So we are getting, we are at 90 meters. So here that the sea level compensated. So it will return this millibar here, and then converting it to the mercury, inch mercury. And then finally the last one will get the pressure, and then this absolute pressure, this sea level pressure. We are passing these two values to get the altitude, and we are getting A. The result of this is stored in A, and we are printing A in meter. And then the serial monitor also prints the A in terms of foot. This is the value. And in all those cases, if it fails, it prints different warnings. and it waits for 5 seconds and reads again. So each of these information block of information is printed every 5 seconds. Here from this device, we are reading here the temperature at as 26.45 degrees Celsius and 79 Fahrenheit, and this is the provided I know from my location, which is 90 meter Ajax, Ontario. You can find your location altitude like you just type your city and the province elevation. As you can see, Google will show you that it's 90 meter above the sea level. If I stop this scrolling, now you will see that the temperature in degrees Celsius and also in Fahrenheit, and also absolute pressure in millibar, and also this is inch of mercury, 29.3. And then the relative sea level pressure is this millibar, and it's in inch of mercury. And then the calculated based on this is 90 meter or 259, which is the same as provided one. I'll show you the pressure because I have to go very high in buildings or maybe mountain to show you the difference, because I have to go a few meters up and down. But I can demonstrate with this heat gun to show you the temperature. So pay attention here that it shows 28 degrees. As you can see, it's already 69 degrees. Every 5 seconds it reads it, so now it should go back down 63, and temperature will decrease slowly back to the room temperatures. Please make sure to subscribe by clicking at the subscribe button in here. Thank you. Thank you for watching the tutorial from Robojax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming videos.